Hey everybody, it's Rich at RMAutodiag, and today we're going to have a look at some basic injector tests. We'll use a multimeter and we'll do some insulation testing. We probably won't use a scope on this one, but we'll do that in another video. So let's go. Right, so just quickly before we start, I'd like to thank any of my new subscribers. Thanks for the support, and if you're not a subscriber, then check out down below and click the subscribe button if you want to follow along. Obviously, usual links and stuff in the description for anything I use and other videos and stuff. So as I say, let's get on to some injector testing. Right, okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to try and identify what type of injectors we've got. We've got four injectors here on this Ford engine. It's a Focus, and we need to know whether they're normal solenoid injectors or piezo injectors, so we want to test piezo injectors. So we're going to do a quick multimeter test, and I'll just get that set up and I'll be back with you. Right, okay, so we've got the plug off the injector. There are only two wires anyway, and I've put some little jumper wires in here, and I've got the multimeter set up, and we're on ohms and we're on an auto ranging meter, so it'll sort out all that stuff for us. What I'm going to do is, if I just clip this onto one lead, make sure it doesn't touch anything, and clip this onto the other, and we should see a resistance of about 200,000 ohms, which we do. So we got 199.2, and we got the K there. So we're in thousands of ohms. So piezo injectors are generally around this mark, usually from about 190 to 210 is, I would say, probably a pretty good range. So we know that this is going to be a piezo injector. If it was just a normal solenoid injector, it would probably be only 1 or 2 ohms. So that's a pretty quick way of identifying it if you're not sure. So we're happy with the fact that that is, you know, in that range of 190 to 210. Between the two terminals. Other tests we could do is we could make sure that the terminals here aren't shorted to the actual injector. So we've just taken the black lead off and we're going to go to the injector, and we shouldn't get anything, which we don't. Do put this one back on and we'll do it and test the other pin as well. So now we're set up there. We'll disconnect the red one and we'll again touch that to the body of the injector, the side of the injector, and OL as well, open circuit. So you're just touching it to the metal part of the injector, and it's a bit difficult to see there. So that's another way of checking. So we don't have any shorts from the inside of the injector to the body. Usually that causes things to cut out and probably not restart. If you've got that situation, you could just disconnect that one injector and try and restart. It would only run on three, but it would prove a point. So next thing we're going to do is we'll get an insulation tester on there and we'll see what comes up with when we do an insulation test. Right, okay, so we've got an insulation tester set up. This is just a Sealey one, but I mean, a lot of people use the mega testers as well. It's quite a popular one. So I've got it set onto insulation test mode, and I've got the leads in the correct places. Again, from the jumper leads, we're just clipped on to the two terminals there. And what we're going to do is we're testing it at 125 volts. That should go up to about 125 as well. If it's lower, say 60 or 70 volts, when it's being passed through, there's going to be an issue, and we're going to be expecting this to be in the mega ohms as well when we do the test. So if we don't get 125-ish back, we've got an issue, and if we don't get it in mega ohms, if it's lower down in the sort of the thousands of ohms, then we'd also be seeing an issue. So if we press it, and there you go. So it can cope with that sort of voltage going through it, and with that going through it, it's at 10 mega ohms. So I'm pretty happy with that. I'd say you can up the range as well. We could go up to 250. I mean, this one will go up to 1,000, but I wouldn't do that on an injector. 250 should be ample, so we'll do the same test again. And there you go, so it will put that 250 through. And again, we're in the mega ohms, so we're happy with that. I appreciate that's not a test that everyone's going to be able to do, but just out of interest there, I thought I'd do it for you guys and show you what's going on. So that's pretty well some of the basic tests that you can do with a multimeter and a an insulation tester. And what we can do in another video at another point is we'll get an oscilloscope set up and we can see what some of the patterns come out of this are as well, and we can go from there. But that's what a good injector looks like. So thanks for watching, and tune into the next one. Cheers.